Hi everyone, it's the English Simmer here, and you guys are about to start watching The Sims 3 Generations Part 61. But before you do, I wanted to give you a quick warning that the sound is going to be terrible during this part. I unfortunately just purchased a webcam, and I forgot that it's gonna record the webcam quality rather than my professional microphone, which I usually use. So the sound quality on this video is really bad, but I still wanted to upload it for you guys because so much happened, and I'm sorry for the terrible quality on it. I really do apologize. Obviously, like, the picture's still fine and things like that, it's just the sound. I completely forgot it. Didn't even cross my mind before I started recording. I probably should have checked before I saved, but I unfortunately didn't. So this is what we're stuck with, and so much happened. So I guess for this one part, I hope you guys can forgive me. I did want to put it up because I felt like it was a really good part, and a lot of things happened, and I discussed a lot of things with you guys. So I am so sorry, but I hope you can all enjoy this video the same. And don't worry, next part, which will be uploaded on Tuesday, will be back to normal quality. I can promise you that. Thanks, guys. I'm really sorry.
Hi everyone, it's the English Simmer here, and welcome back to Let's Play The Sims 3 Generations Part 61. This Let's Play has not ended. For some reason, a bunch of you thought that this has ended, probably because I said I was going to end it at 60 parts a few, like, 10 parts ago or so, but there was a lot to tie up, so I have been thinking about it, and I'm gonna end this at 65, so we have like four more episodes after this one, so don't worry about that. We still have the prom to look forward to. And if you are very, like, eager and have already noticed, Ice has had a baby girl. Alexis gave birth at, like, I don't know, like 6 hours ago maybe, and the baby is called Abby, and it is a girl. So gurgling baby girls are delightful additions to any family. So Ice is now a dad. He is the boyfriend of Alexis, and we now have a daughter, which is crazy. She isn't gonna live with us. I'm not gonna move Alexis in, for those of you who have been asking me, and that's just because we already have quite a few Sims in this household, and with Alexis and also the baby, it would just be crazy. Maybe, like, for season two, like if I do bring it back for a quote unquote season two, maybe we'll move Ice out, like he'll find his own place with Alexis. I think that would be really cute. Like, we'd still visit him and stuff, kind of like we do with the Frosts, but he would have his own place with his daughter and his. Maybe we'll even get them married at the beginning and then move them off into another place, and they'll focus like by themselves. We'll just go and visit. We'll obviously stay focused with our generations that we have currently, which I think will be a really cute idea for like the second season. It would be like these kids growing up and then also having their cousin, like their cousin will be growing up with them, because I think basically Alexis is having a party right now. That's where we're heading off to, and we're gonna go head on over there so Ice can see his new baby. Oh, he's taking patterns. Motorbike. Okay. But yeah, Ice Frost just captured the memory of having a baby. Parenthood is a monumentous occasion that all Sims should experience. Ice is now the father of a new baby girl. Alexis just gave birth to a baby girl named Abby. So that's what our daughter's called. She's called Abby. Oh, please tell me that you're in Alexis. Okay, she is. Whew, I was gonna say, it better not be a glitchy. This is such a nice house. Oh, look, Everest is here. I want to see the baby girl. Oh, and look, she has her own nursery and everything. Noel's here. Marcella, I don't know who she is, but she kind of looks like she has a boy's nursery. But this is Abby. This is Alexis's daughter. I didn't name her. She like randomly came up called Abby. She is so cute. I know like all babies look the same, but look at those eyes. Oh my goodness, she's adorable. Right, let's have Ice meet his daughter. We'll snuggle her, we'll play with her, we'll give her a bottle, And then we'll snuggle her again. The quad. That's what you do. It's the top quad for babies in The Sims 3. He's currently berating her ignorance. Don't go near our baby, Hector. This is our baby girl. We're looking after her. And I don't like the fact that Noel's here. I really don't like the fact that he's there. But I'm so glad that this baby's been born. So cute. Oh, Ice is gonna have his daddy moments. Oh my goodness, this is so cute. He just. Oh, she's crying. Give her a bottle, Ice. Oh my goodness, I love. Look at his legs. He looks like a chicken. Liam, you are a chicken. Oh, I'm gonna turn down their voices a bit. Sorry, guys, if you do like to hear voices in The Sims. It's just. Sometimes it just gets too noisy when they're at parties. Like, super loud. And babies crying and everything. So, this is a really nice house. I wonder if Danny still lives here. How many bedrooms is it? It's got like two massive bedrooms. One en suite there, another en suite there, a kid's nursery place, and then another bathroom down here. This is huge! I forgot how big this house was. That's crazy. Sorry if you hear any noises in the background of this episode. I don't know how loud it's actually going to be on mic. It sounds quite loud in reality, but it's just because we have like a meeting going on downstairs for. One of my friends is on a sports team, and we all have meetings every so often. So they're all playing FIFA downstairs. So if you hear them, you know how it is with boys and their FIFA. They just go crazy, and they'll probably start shouting abuse at each other and banging on the side of No, don't put her in a crib. No. Snuggle her. No, I want you to pick her back up. Snuggle her again. And then play with her. And we're gonna kiss Alexis. We've not seen Alexis in so long. We're going to do a heat of moment kiss. You know, she just gave birth to our baby girl. She's going psycho and she's like, get me out of that room. Too many people there for Alexis right now. We're also going to hold her hands and compliment her appearance. Maybe we'll stay over. Maybe we'll ask if we can stay over, you know? That'd be kind of cute. Everyone's just kind of taking care of themselves, which is good. That means I don't have to worry about any of them. They'll all look after themselves. Oh, he checked for monsters. Oh, are you kidding me? It's so annoying. Oh, that's loud. I think I might just have my speakers turned up a bit too loud for this game right now. Oh, these two. They're still cute. I still love them together. I know that a lot of you have been saying that it should have been Danny, but honestly, I think him and Alexis are adorable. We're gonna give her some flowers as well. Where is she? Oh, she's gonna go make some food, I guess. Oh, I love them. And now they have their own little girl. And she's so adorable as well. Like, how could you not love that face? Those eyes are so freaking cute. She's gonna be stunning, I bet. Like, she has Ice's dad, who is very good looking Sim. Like, and then you have Alexis, who's like supermodel standards, basically, with her like cat eyes and stuff like that. It's crazy. She's gonna be such a cute child, I swear. I'm proud of our genes. You know, Jack and Elsa had strong genes. Extremely strong. Is there any leftovers? We're gonna have a quick meal of green salad because Ice is getting kind of hungry. And then I think we will ask her if we can stay over. Oh, she's prepared something. We're just gonna grab a plate then before everyone else comes down. And then we are going to. Can I stay over? Be cheeky. You know, we have a baby now, we should be allowed to stay over. Oh, here's Danny! Is she still with Noel? She's gonna go talk to him. I wanna see if they're still together. I don't know. They kind of had a little thing going on, but she is now an elder, hence why she has those strange pigtails going on, because she aged up, and this is like default hair for aging up, which is kind of annoying because you always have to change it back. They don't seem to be romantically involved. What we're gonna do though, I think we're gonna send everyone to sleep. Oh, he's asking for a bedtime story. Winter, you cutie pie. You need to go to bed. I did do up as a girl's room. This is the girl's room, and this is the boy's room. So, Binky and the other one, Binky and Summer, are in this room, and then the boys are in here. So, we're gonna have him go to sleep, and she can read him a bedtime story, I suppose. Why don't you practice illicit activities, naughty patterns? Tut tut. Right, hopefully Alexis says we can stay over. That'd be quite nice. How's the baby? I feel as if we need to keep checking on her because we don't live with her, so we're not giving her all of us. She just comes up and laughs at Noel. What? Danny, hands off our child. Or is she going to bed? Danny sleeps in the kids' room. Of course she does. Of bloody course she does. So there we go. We're gonna ask if we can stay over. I don't think he has anything romantically involved with her. Cause sure, make yourself at home. Thank you. We will. Ice Frost is having a sleep over. He will never forget stick to staying up late night giggling with his friend. This is bound to make a memorable night of bonding. Okay, whatever you say, game. Oh, he's asking everyone for a bedtime story. Has he not got one yet? Why haven't none of them gone to bed? Seriously, get to sleep, Sims. Go and sleep right now. He's just asking everyone for a bedtime story. Belle just ignored him and slept in the thing. Belle, you biatch. Is she gonna read him a bedtime story? She said she is. Whether she will or not is a whole different matter. Oh, she's gonna. Looks like she's grabbing a book to read to sleep. I don't know where he's gonna sleep though, because apparently there's monsters under his bed. Maybe he'll sleep in Ice's room, considering Ice isn't there for the night, because we all know what he is gonna be up to. Where are you going, buddy? Oh, what bed did he check under? Apparently his doesn't have any monsters. But Binky's gonna go be a cute big sister and read to him. How adorable! Oh my goodness, look at these two. That's so cute. And she's teaching him the culinary skill. She's making it really interesting. I'm quite happy. Right, as long as she's reading him to sleep, I guess after she does that. She can go to sleep too. Oh no, Jack is getting pretty old and won't live forever. No. Whenever we get that notification, it takes like one part and they're dead. Who the hell are you and why do you live here? Alyssa, I did not put you in this. Oh look, Ben still lives here. Ben's so balding, it's actually hilarious. That's so funny. I think we're gonna have a woohoo. Oh, I'm so glad that Ice is finally a dad. He's always been the older brother or uncle who's always looked after all the other kids. And now he's got his own to look after and dote on. And it's a little girl as well. She's gonna be such. Are you two flirting? Alexis! She was so just flirting with Ben. Are you kidding me? I saw that. They were getting closer. But he's not feeling sad by the looks of
Yeah.
it, so maybe it's nothing serious. Oh, it is something serious. He is upset. Ooh, well, she's our girlfriend. They're just gonna woohoo in the shower. Where are we gonna sleep? Jared's in that bed. This Alyssa person's in here. Where are we meant to sleep? I'm not sleeping with Jared. I'm sorry, but I'm not spooning with him. I can't do that. I'm not gonna do that to Ice. Died of pride. Oh, and he got a raise. Sweet. A little extracurricular activity out of the sim, out of the house is just what the thing. It's just the thing to put a spring in a sim's step. Aw, cute. But he really needs to sleep, and we've not got anywhere to sleep. I want to watch these two. I've got my eye on her. If she is cheating on us, she literally just gave birth to our child. She can't do this to us. Not to Ice. Ice is a babe. Please, Alexis, don't do this. I'm going to be really upset if you do. But where are we going to sleep? Like, legit now. What are they? Are they going to watch the stars? If they are, I'm going to get in a fight with Ben. Ben, you know. You know. Sorry, guys. Don't know what that shouting was. Ben, you know that she's our girl, and you know that she just gave birth. What are you doing? This is not okay. This is not. I do not like the looks of this. Are they gonna? They're doing it. They're watching the stars. Ben, I told you not to go there, and you went there. And Alexis is. She's initiating it. No! Alexis, why did I make her non-committal? I thought she was the good choice. I thought she was. And now she's not. And this breaks my heart because she's just had a baby. Competing branches of the organization are looking at Patton's fiancé. He can be a thief or he can be an evildoer. Ministry of Evil. We're gonna go for evil. We're gonna go there. This is. Oh my goodness. Alexis, I thought you were the one, okay? I thought you were the one for Ice. Where's she gone, anyway? How dare she? Oh, it's really peeved me off. Come on, Ice. Get your little butt over here. We're gonna give him a rude introduction. We're gonna fight with him. I wanna fight with you. I'm gonna fight with you. I'm gonna give you a rude introduction. I'm gonna fight. Ice, get over there now. I know that you don't want to be out here. I did not put you in that either. I swear that is not the outfit I chose for you. Maybe it is. He looks like something out of Grease with his hair and that jacket. Ben. We're gonna argue with him. We're gonna mock his appearance because he's bald and he's not very old, so we're gonna mock that because we're gonna point out his flaws and we're gonna insult his home and we're also gonna argue with him and we're also going to petty jab him. Yeah, we might be unforgivably rude, but you literally just like made out with our girlfriend right in front of us, which is not okay. The mother of our child, and you cross boundaries, my friend. It's not okay with me. He's like, yeah, guess what? Your home sucks. I didn't even want to be here. I'm just here for my daughter. You know what? Maybe we'll just take the daughter and we'll move her into our house. Because that sounds like a good plan to me. I think you guys. I just want to get into a fight with this guy. I just want to insult his home again, and I want to argue with him again, and I want to point out his flaws, and I want to give him a mean high five and imply his mother is a llama. But I think you guys should leave your comments down below of what you think we should do. Do you think, I'm going to continue this, do you think we should, one, stay with Alexis and keep the baby as they are and have them just live separate lives, basically? Number two, oh, the baby's crying. Right, baby's crying. She's more important than anything right now. We're gonna go give her a bottle, change her diaper, play with her, and snuggle her. Because Ice is a grown up who wants to look after his child. But yeah, we can either stay with Alexis and just do the plan of what I was planning on doing anyway, having them live separately, but Ice look after her. Two, leave Alexis, and that's it. Take Abby with us. We can leave Alexis and just forget all about Abby, which I kind of don't want to do because I doubt Ice would do that, just being the person that Ice is. Or we can, three, take Abby, have her live with us, and then maybe try and get back in Danny's good books. You know, like Alexis, she's a heartbreaker. She always has been, pretty much always will be. And I think honestly, we should like take care of their baby, and I don't know, guys. It's one of those options, and you guys should choose for me because I obviously called it wrong with Alexis, and I'm sorry to all of those wonderful, wonderful people who are like, Molly, don't go with Alexis. She's just gonna break your heart, or Molly, she's not the girl for Ice. And you guys were right. No matter how much I wanted you to be wrong, you were right. So I should, main thing of this story is that I should really just listen to you guys because you guys pretty much always have it right and I was an idiot. This is why, guys, you don't let looks get in front of personality because you know, Dani was pretty, but she was the average girl next door pretty, whereas Alexis was the stunner. And now it's just all gone. Abby's just, oh, we're gonna go home actually. I feel bad leaving our baby here, but she's even got Alexis's name. We will change her name if she does move in with us. We'll change it to Frost, because that's his name. But Ice, head home. I'm sorry, Abby. I know that we should stay. Don't flirt with us. I am not in the mood to flirt with anyone right now. Where did Alexis even go to? She literally ran off. Oh, the cheek of the woman. She gets with her, like, basically her best friend who she's grown up with all her life, who we trusted, gets with him and then leaves. We're gonna eat some strawberry pancakes. Why isn't it a snow day? It's so snowy. It's so annoying. But I'm gonna skip part of today because it is prom and I kind of do want to show prom off in this episode. So I'm just gonna skip through the rest of the day until it's prom time and I will get back to you guys then. Guys, I'm crying. I'm basically crying right now. This is not okay. This is like the worst part of Generations ever. Oh, Jax died. Oh, the last one. We started this Let's Play with Jack and Elsa, and now Jax died. And I'm not okay. I'm not a happy bunny. I can't believe he's dead. He was our dad, and we played with him for like 50 parts. And then we carried on to 60 parts with his daughter and his son and his grandchildren, and we visited and we laughed and we cried, and there's been ups and downs, and there's been arguments, and there's been happy times and marriages and proposals and births and middle life crises where he wanted to divorce Elsa, but they stuck through it all. And now he's finally passed away, and I am basically crying. He did live a full life. He has four wonderful grandchildren. Well, two and a step, well, adopted and a step, I guess you could say. He has five amazing kids, and I am so sad. I am literally almost in tears, and I can't believe that I'm almost in tears over a sim. I doubt you guys can believe that, unless you guys obviously have been watching from the start and have, like, enough emotion and connection with Jack as I do. Everyone's mourning. I can't believe Jack's dead. Are you kidding me? Why are they not mourning? Literally, why is no one mourning? This is so sad. Maybe they just haven't realized it yet. Oh, Jack. Jack Frost. Oh, that's so sad. We're gonna have Belle. I know I hate doing this, Belle. I hate doing this to you, but we're gonna have to go visit the graveyard. We're gonna oh, even seeing the name, it's so sad. We're gonna go to the graveyard. And we're going to manage the dead. We have to tell the grandkids and everything when they get back from school. You are not going to be stopped being friends with Winter. At least the teenagers, at least they have prom, which will kind of take the mind off things, I guess. Not really. Oh, that's so sad. Right, Wave, go and take a shower. Binky, you need a shower too. Yeah, you can. No, don't do your homework. Screw homework. We're gonna take a shower. And people are really loud outside. I don't know what's going on right now. The dance is at 6 p.m. You better hurry up and get ready. We need to find Jack in all of this craziness. Jack Frost. Oh, we have to make another grave. This is so sad. I'm not okay. Oh, he's gonna have to go. Oh, Olaf's tombstone's like really covered. Here lies Kevin. He will be missed dearly. That's Elsa. Right, what we're gonna do is we're gonna move Kevin. Sorry, Kevin, but Elsa and Jack need to be together. Jack, you are going here. And we should probably put some flowers on, but we'll leave it for a little bit because it's snowy anyway, so there's not really much point of putting flowers on. Oh, I want to edit his epitaph though. Here lies Jack Frost, always love. Here lies Jack Frost. Our heart. And what should I put? Like, here lies Jack Frost. Like, I'm trying to think of a pun, but this is not working. I think I'm just in a deep, dark depression that Jack can only pull me out of. Here lies Jack Frost. I don't even know what to put. Loved always sounds good to me, but we just got rid of it. I don't know. Here lies Jack Frost, I don't know. I'm too grief-stricken to be doing this. I can't think of things when I'm crying over a sim. I'm just gonna put RIP for now. You guys should also leave in the comments down below what we should engrave Jack's thing with because he means a lot. Belle, you can head home. Why is no one grieving though? Like, this is not okay. Why don't you mourn over him? Who needs to go to work? Ice, go to work, you loser. He has work today as well. How are the kids? They're just gonna do their homework. You need to actually grab something to eat. I'm fairly sure I also already have them in like prom get up, so I don't have to edit anything up really. Like, they already have all their formal wear that they need. Summer, can you do your homework? And can you do your homework? Where's Ice? Okay. He has gone to work. What does he need? Band members. We're gonna have him chill with musicians so that he can get his Bel Bianchi is mourning because of the loss of dear Jack Frost. This sad event is one that she will always remember. Oh, I'm sorry, Belle. Patterns, where are you? We're gonna have her. I don't know why they haven't got the mourning moonlet. It's really weird. Like, surely they should have it. I don't even know anymore. Apparently, neither of them are mourning. Which is kind of sucky because kind of thought they would be. Do we have bills to pay? Yep. Only 900 simoleons. Damn, why can't Sims 4 be like that? So annoying. They're gonna go head to prom in a few minutes. So we'll just see how their prom turns out. Hopefully they get with each other, because that's what I really want. And why are our proms always in winter? It's so annoying because they go to prom in their outerwear rather than their like clothes, which she's just gonna be at prom in this, which is kind of really annoying. Can we get them changed before they do it? Right, Wave, can you change into your formal wear and then go to prom? And Binky, come on, leave the house. Oh, he just automatically does it anyway, so there's really no point. We'll just keep them in their outerwear. My tongue feels really fuzzy right now because I drank a coffee before this and like burnt all of my tongue. So now it feels like when you get like that fuzzy feeling, and it's really gross. I've been trying to ignore it for like the last half an hour, and it's just got to me, like completely. Right. I think we're just gonna speed through prom, to be completely honest. I just want to see the notifications, really. I just want to see if they like have any romance on the table or anything like that. The kids are doing pretty good. We're gonna watch TV. We're just gonna have both of them watch some TV. Chill out, you know. Their granddad just died. What's that on the floor? What is that? Crackling Knacker Bell. What? Oh, that's like the witch. It's a witch gnome. I don't know why she's. Maybe she's cold. Binky begged the entire school to vote for her for prom queen. It paid off because she is one. Wave was ecstatic to accept the crown and thanked everyone for rigging the votes. So they both. She got prom queen. My classmates like me. They really like me. And he got prom king. Fist pump. Clearly, your classmates recognize greatness when they see it. Basically, they both rigged their votes. Oh, only our Sims could that happen. Here we go. Here's the romance. Wave has been getting Binky punch the entire night and making sure she's having a good time. Wave's attention to detail is making a good impression on Binky. Wave spotted a wardrobe malfunction and they're romantically involved. Boom! Sims in the bag. Yes. I'm so glad that they're romantically involved now. That's so cute. Oh, he's gonna go ask for a bedtime story again. I hope Belle actually listens to him this time, doesn't just blow him off. That'd be quite awkward. Binky had a mishap on the dance floor and fell flat on her face. That sounds like something Binky would do. And another wardrobe malfunction. Come on, Belle. Don't ignore your son. Go and read a bedtime story. It's only like 8 p.m. Winter, you big wuss. Hopefully we get some snow days soon, though. That'll be quite fun. Because then we can have like Belle take the kids out and the teens out for like snow day fun. That'll be fun. How many times did I just say fun in that sentence? Everyone looked amazing in their suits and dresses. Binky couldn't stop checking people out. Excuse me, you're romantically involved anyway. Wave decided to ask a loner classmate to dance because he felt bad for him. Instead of a thanks, he threw his drink in Wave's face. What? What a D-bag! That's what you get being nice. He was denied a dance by a loser. First romance. Oh my goodness. That's so cute. I'm so glad that they're romantically involved. This made me super happy. Oh, and she's reading him to sleep in her bed. And another wardrobe malfunction. What is wrong with kids these days? Wave thought the backdrop for prom pictures looked amazing. This is so cute. Winter's such a needy child. Summer's just there, like really laid back, like, yeah, I don't need a bedtime story. I'm an independent woman who don't need no bedtime stories. But Wave is just, Winter's just like, give it to me. Give me all the attention. I suppose he was adopted, so it is nice to give him the attention every once in a little while, I suppose. How's Chestnut? We've literally done nothing. Another wardrobe malfunction. These kids are sleuths, I swear. Wade got into a fight with a schoolmate because he looked at him funny. Maybe a little discipline might prevent him from behaving badly. Wave's prom is turning out a lot like Ice's prom. I think, oh, Chestnut's asleep. We're gonna pay him some attention, but I guess if he's asleep, then that's okay with me. Oi! You were meant to be going to sleep. Go and sleep right now. And his mood swings over. Oh my, Binky just spotted a three-eyed llama. Help! I think Binky might have been drinking. Think she might have had a little bit too much punch, because I don't think three-eyed llamas exist. Wave couldn't stop staring at the lights. Yeah, these both are on something. They've both been drinking far too much alcohol at prom. The aliens are coming for Wave. Both white girl wasted right there. Definition of white girl wasted at prom is seeing a three-eyed llama and thinking you're being abducted by aliens. That's when you know you've had too much. Binky built up her courage and asked her crush for a dance. Unfortunately, they made an excuse and snuck away. What? Surely her crush would be Ice. But we would be Wave. But the school dance is over and they are romantically involved. They both got denied for a dance, neither with each other. But they are romantically involved. She was prom queen, he was prom king. Of course, it was all gonna happen. That's just what high school dreams are all about, right? That's what everyone wants. I don't know, because we don't have prom queen or king in England. But in America, that's literally all I hear about, like, from American movies and stuff like that. But I know they're not a good representation, but it's a big deal, right? I'm fairly sure it is. But that's the end of this part, guys. I hope you all enjoyed. It was a really eventful part. So much happened. Like I said, do leave your comments down below of what you think should happen with Alexis. Whether we should take Abby and go back to Danny or stay with Alexis and try and work it out. But you know what? She's always going to be a heartbreaker. So I kind of think we should just either get out of there whilst we can or go to someone else. Just plain and simple. But thank you guys for watching so much. I love you all, and I will speak to you all in the next part. Don't forget to give this video a big thumbs up if you did enjoy it. I love you all. Bye, guys!